In 1958, Walter Jacobson was at Columbia University in New York studying political science and living above a chock full of nuts restaurant on Broadway. Apparently one or both of these experiences prepared him to be anchorman and commentator at Channel 2. Would you please welcome Walter Jacobson?
Winners in the individual category were announced just before tonight's telecast, but we're here to honor them now so everybody can see. Category 10A is for outstanding achievement for individual excellence for performers who appear on camera. The winners are Mort Crim, reporter, narrator, A Matter of Policy. William, I'll read all the names and then maybe they can come up and get their Emmys. William J. Norris, performer, the Joseph Jefferson Awards, also Channel 2. Dick Orkin and Bert Berdis, performers, the 1977 Joseph Jefferson Awards, also Channel 2. Norma Quarles, reporter, Urban Journal, that's Channel 5. And Marty Robinson, narrator, Treasures of Tutankhamun, Channel 11.
Well, these awards are for individual excellence, but in television, as we all know, there is no such thing as individual achievement. It's all a team effort. And for my part in the matter of policy, I'd like to thank Scott Craig, who truly is one of the greatest producers in our business, Jim Hatfield and Molly Bedell, and our management and crew, without which this honor would not be possible. Thank you all.
Very succinctly, I'd like to thank the gracious Essie Cupsnip and the staff at WBBM-TV for making it possible for me to have this. Thank you.
Ms. Waller? I'd also like to thank Essie and Scott Craig for providing such a wonderful format for Dick Orkin and myself. Unfortunately, Dick couldn't be here today. He thought it was tomorrow night at Airy Crown. He's authorized me to take home two of these, though. Thanks very much.
I'm thrilled and delighted to be back in the city where I started in the broadcasting business 13 years ago. My son said before I left tonight to please thank him. So thank you, Larry, and thank you to my daughter, Susan. And also a special thanks to Paul Hogan and to Charlie Boyle. Thank you all.
Now in category 10B, outstanding achievement for individual excellence, for individual excellence of persons whose achievement is non-performing. The winners are Renee Ferguson, writer-reporter for Waller High School on Channel 2. John Kennamer, audio engineer, Hansel and Gretel, that's Channel 11. Carl Langenberg, cinematographer for Treasures of Tutankhamun, Channel 11.
In order to go undercover as a high school student, a reporter, especially a television news reporter, has to be new in town. And I had been in Chicago for just more than a month when I went to Waller High School. And so I would like to say a special thank you to the management team at Channel 2, who were so tremendous in supporting me and sticking by me and believing in me. And I'd also like to say a very special thanks to the children of Waller High School, who I believe in their hearts probably knew my secret, but who dared to share their secrets with me. Thank you.
Well, I want to say a special thanks to a tremendous production team at Channel 11. Everybody that works there in engineering, production, and everything that has to do with putting a show together is probably one of the most fantastic teams I've ever worked with, commercial and non-commercial. I want to thank each and every one of them. Well, a special thanks to Dick Carter, the director, on the Hansel and Gretel show that we did. Thank you, Chicago. Thank all of you. Thank you very much. Appreciate it.
If you all remember the TED exhibit, it was inundated with people, lines for miles. We had the extraordinary opportunity of filming it in the wee small hours of the morning by ourselves, maybe one, three other people. I think we were sufficiently rewarded just having that experience. I'd like to mention some names that did the show. Don Knox, Valerie Gentile, my right hand, David Moyer, who helped me with the lighting very much. The station for letting us do it.
I've noticed tonight, local news here is different than the West Coast. We have one minority, one WASP, one Oriental, and one guy with a bad toop. I don't know why that is. It's a regional preference of some kind. Our next history tape is from WSNS Channel 44, one of the Chicago's UHF stations. That means ultra-high frequency. If it's on a card, I read it. A big part of Channel 44's tradition is sports broadcasting, and here's a look.
Channel 44 became the eighth television station in Chicago, April 5th, 1970. Chicagoans were intrigued by a thing called instant news, but they soon met lots of personalities, some of whom still make the Windy City their home. Then in 1972, with the arrival of Edward L. Morris as general manager, Channel 44 began to find its place in the hearts of Chicago's sports fans, the Chicago Bulls, the Cougars, even the outdoor sportsmen. And now Purdue, Indiana basketball, DePaul University basketball, college football, boxing, NHL hockey, tennis, soccer, bowling, and most of all, Chicago White Sox baseball. Channel 44, programming Chicago sports fans love.